Hi Gemini, it's Elle here to do your July 2019 general reading. It's a general reading, so it may not resonate with you, but if it does, please like, share, comment, subscribe to the channel. I am in the process of getting my nails done. Please do not look close. It's crazy. So some of you Geminis are dealing with a male energy where there's a lot of gossip surrounding the connection. There's always gossip surrounding the connection. You know, either, you know, maybe you guys weren't, you seem like you were very opposite, or this person just wasn't, some people felt like this person isn't or wasn't good enough for you, or vice versa. There's always been gossip surrounding the nature of the relationship. There's also been a lot of money being dished out from one side. It's unequal. Or someone provided the other with a lot of opportunity to make money. Somebody, in regards to shared resources, someone is, you know, has a lot more than the other. And this could be that the Gemini has more than the other, than the guy that he or she is dealing with. And Gemini provided the guy or the girl with opportunity, or is just giving them money. Now the Gemini is seeing that this is kind of codependent and toxic. Maybe the rumor or rumors that were there in the beginning have always, you know, they're somewhat true. There's also a Gemini, there's a lot of work that you need to do in order to get something off the ground, to get to a place of stability, maybe in some entrepreneurial endeavor. Do know that what you're doing is going to get you, trust that it's going to get you to where you want to land. Be strong in your convictions. There may be other people around you who just don't believe in what you're doing, or they don't respect it, maybe because they don't see the outward result just yet. They just see a lot of effort and energy being expended. Okay, so let's jump into it. There's also a Gemini is doing a lot of work and trying to be strong in a commitment, in a relationship, something to do with children. There's also a Gemini spying on someone that they're dealing with. This could be a Scorpio person. The relationship started, but it's like one of those relationships where, yeah, it started, but it was ending also. Do you get that? Where, like, this was, in a sense, it was never going anywhere. So, it just wasn't meant to be. Okay, so let's see what's going on for the Gemini. Yeah, the Devil card came out in the pre-shuffle. Temperance, you, Four of Wands, Knight of Pentacles. Okay, so some of you, there might be someone who comes back and says that they want to salvage a relationship. They're willing to compromise. They're willing to move heaven and hell just to be with you. They've got their emotions under wrap, under control. This may be you, Gemini. This offer, maybe from you or from another person, has been long time coming. There might have been a very toxic nature within a particular relationship, a home. At the very core of you or someone you're dealing with was toxicity, was a brokenness, was negativity, is a lower vibrational everything. They can mask that, you know, this negativity long enough for a person to like them. But when you get to know this person, they're highly negative, pessimistic, petty, opportunist. Think of all the bad things you can think of. This is that person. The Gemini may be at a place of making a choice and analyzing this relationship, maybe in regards to if they want to offer, if they want to continue to work on the relationship, or vice versa, someone is doing this in regards to you, Gemini. Also, there may be a Gemini saying, you know, I've changed, I want to make it better. Someone may, a Gemini may all of a sudden want to propose to a particular person they have children with or want children with. There is or was a previous relationship. There's a lot of sexual chemistry. There's a real strong physical dynamic here. Almost as if this is, for some of you, it's karmic. Some of you, it's kind of twin flame, soulmate. Definitely the choice has to be made. What are you doing here, Gemini? What is going on here? Are you accepting the offer? Yeah, it says stay strong. Know that whatever convictions you have, know that it's going to lead you and land you where you want to be. Don't be unwavering in what it is you're after, what it is you're trying to pursue. Yep, that's you. So this says that there might be a particular person that is saying, I've changed, I want to come back, I want to work on this, we can work on this, let's not let this go. It benefits them more to be with you, around you, in connection with you. You have to make the choice, is this something that you want? Yeah, you have to, are you accepting the offer? Are you going to reignite the flame, the love? Also, some of you are a bit scared in regards to extending an offer. The Four of Pentacles. Four of Pentacles in the World. That you've come into a level of maturity, either in finance, you have matured in finances, you are where you want to be. You're not exactly sure if you want to keep giving to a situation that's not going to lead you where or to what you want. Two of Pentacles, once again, about your money, your earned income, your possessions, material possessions, habits and old habits, work ethics. It says that you may be doing two different things. You may have two different jobs that you are giving your energy and effort to, because you're trying to build, either some of you are trying to get to the next level monetarily or in regards to maybe self-employment or getting to another status. You feel like you have matured beyond where you are, or you've matured so much, and you are set in your finances, you know, in the physical of life, that you have to weigh up the opportunity, the business deal, the love affair that you're involved in. It looks like you may rush and get truth, forward movement. But where are you moving to? Let's see. You might be just telling the person, you know, I need to focus on myself, my health, wealth, and happiness. Or someone is saying this to you, and that and that they're going to make the choice to move on and to make peace with this this relationship. Let's see what's going on element wise. Okay, so someone, either you or someone else, is not accepting an offer to make the situation right. I think you got so serious within yourself and within this relationship, and you put your foot down. So then this person comes along with this long, this taking forever to actually be real and true and genuine about changing the dynamic of the relationship. But you don't even care that now they want to change, because you kind of feel like it's based in the fact that they're scared of losing you. For some of you, it's a meal ticket. And then for some of you, you are the meal ticket. And then for some of you, you know, it's vice versa. You're afraid of losing the other person because they provide you with, you know, finances and some type of status. You're concerned about how you look to the world. Reputation. Okay. Some of you have a home, life, children with someone, and they want to work on the situation. You say no. No, I don't want to. Okay. In regards to my Geminis dealing with air signs, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Five of Clubs, okay. Eight of Clubs. So, for some of you dealing with air signs, you might want to have new love and new marriage with this person. There's a need to talk about the trouble and the jealousy within this relationship, to either push it forward and you guys, you know, be great together, or to release and let this go. You would have to have the strength to deal with the fact that maybe somebody gets a lot of attention also, or someone has a lot of suitors, or there's always someone vying for the other's attention. Okay, all right, so my Gemini's dealing with water signs, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Let's see. Gemini's dealing with water signs, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Queen of Clubs. Okay. So, okay. All right, three cards. It's only supposed to be two, but these two came out. All right. With Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, it looks as if this is a dynamic where someone is highly attractive. They attract a lot of attention and energy. They're talkative. They may be funny or like funny things. This may be your person. They either have a business that they're embarking on, your person. There might be a bit of separation here because someone has a newfound philosophy of personal philosophy, maybe due to traveling, something about cross-cultural. You guys may not be even the same ethnic background or ethnicity in some sort, but you guys are together in a union. You may even be married. this person is focused on their long-term goals. There's a lot of single or singular plans that this person makes, but it will benefit, I guess, the family unit. But there's a lot of singular energy here where this person just does what they want to do in regards to, you know, long-term goals, finances, their reputation. This person, and they also may be concerned about family too. Okay. All right, those dealing with fire signs, Aries, Sagittarius, Leo. You may be telling the Aries, Sagittarius, Leo that, you know, it's a no. You're concerned about your own health, wealth, and happiness. You at this point, you just need to focus on you and what makes you happy, because this might be an unhappy dynamic right now. You also want them to tell the truth about their motivation. You want them to be clear about their motivation with you, their intention about, you know, this relationship. Okay, those of you dealing with Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, Earth signs. All right, Jack of Clubs. All right. It looks like this person really desires you, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Or they could just be concerned about their own desires. One more for that. Yeah. They may. They may really just desire to come toward you. There's something holding them up. They don't think very positively about partnership, about merging the two lives. You guys may be together, but you may live separate. This person may give you money, but there's no shared resources or money. There are no home loans, business, nothing, no assets between the two of you. But this, because this person is concerned about themselves and not ready to make an offer in regards to actually merging life with. Okay. We're gonna go over to the other side and see what's going on in regards to this reading. It looks like the Gemini's turning down an offer, or someone's turning down the Gemini's offer, or the Gemini is scared to offer, or someone is scared to offer to the Gemini. Let's leave you with a word of or a card of advice from the angel answers. All right, so some of you looking for a timeline in the near future. So let's expound on the energy for the air signs, the water signs, fire and earth. Okay. All right, thank you guys. The link for the extended is below. Take care. Bye.